In 2024, Northern Water collaborated with the U.S. Forest Service on two very important stream restoration projects within the East Troublesome Fire burn scar. One being the Kauffman Creek Restoration Project in the Upper Willow Creek watershed, and the second being the Stillwater Creek Restoration Project, with Stillwater Creek being a direct tributary of Lake Granby. Both of these projects will really result in the improvement of ecological health in those specific stream reaches, which will improve water quality in our collections reservoirs. So at Kauffman, we installed approximately 39 post-assisted log structures. And then on Stillwater Creek, we did similar work. We created about 40 post-assisted log structures, or PALs there, which are wood structures that are anchored into the bank and the bed of the stream reach. These post-assisted log structures will cause a slowing of flows, sediment retention, allowing flows to better spread onto the floodplain.
We're putting them in the stream channels along the floodplain to catch that sediment, to catch that debris when it comes down in these rain events, snowmelt events, and then it will eventually bring that sediment level up, bring the water table up below it, and become a healthier landscape and a healthier riparian area.
It's really going to cause those plant communities to take off and really become more dense, healthier, and will help the landscape become more resilient to future fires by enhancing the width of the wetted vegetation of the valley bottoms where we have that riparian vegetation. These post-assisted log structures, although right now are above bed, very obvious visually, slowly but surely, they're going to cause raising of the channel bed, and a lot of these structures will actually be buried within the channel bed. Some of the woody material may fall off of the structures, become part of the bed and banks, or be transported downstream. Overall, what you're going to see 5 to 10 years down the road is maybe no structures at all. The East Troublesome Fire was the second largest fire in the state of Colorado history. It burned approximately 193,000 acres in Grand County. Now, this area is really the primary collections area for the Colorado Big Thompson Project. Approximately 1 million people and over 600,000 acres of irrigated agriculture really depend on the watersheds for a supplemental water supply. So enhancing and restoring areas impacted by the East Troublesome Fire is really key to Northern Water's mission of delivering that quality water. It's in our best interests and the region's best interests to restore the forest, to improve the watersheds, to protect the streams that feed those reservoirs, and make sure that the water coming from those streams is of the utmost quality. So restoring these reaches on Kauffman and Stillwater Creek will ultimately result in sediment retention in those stream reaches, which will prevent sedimentation in our collections reservoirs. It will result in better nutrient uptake from the vegetation, the riparian and wetland vegetation along the streams, which will improve water quality in our collections reservoirs.
We want these to be healthy riparian areas, water systems. We want clean water to be coming down the hills, and we want this habitat to be reestablished. Once we have that reestablished on the landscape, that's going to be a benefit to multiple resources.
2020 was a catastrophic fire year in the state of Colorado, with East Troublesome coming in at just under 200,000 acres. During the initial response phase for 2021-2022, we really focused on the protection of private properties, critical infrastructure. In addition to that, we did some aerial mulching activities to help stabilize slopes and prevent significant debris flows in those locations. In 2023, we turned our focus to U.S. Forest Service lands, and the first project we implemented on Forest Service lands was the Aquatic Organism Passage Culvert at Stillwater Creek. That project was a great success in 2023, and during the winter of 23-24, we began looking at the long-term recovery on Forest Service lands, really focusing on developing a program of work for each year through approximately 2030. The first elements of that program were the Kauffman Creek and Stillwater Creek restoration projects. Both of these projects turned out excellent by all accounts, really showing what our partnership with U.S. Forest Service can accomplish.
We're just thankful that we have partners to engage and help us meet some of these objectives. It's not only that we have a common goal recovering these landscapes, but individually we don't have the capacity or the abilities to do this alone. So that's really where the partnerships are coming into play, is we're helping each other accomplish this work, setting us up to have a continued relationship many years in the making.